गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास सिक्स स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर ऑल वेलकम इन फिजिक्स क्लास. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू जस्ट रीकैप व्हाट ऑल यू हैव स्टडीड इन प्रीवियस क्लास, दैट इज ऑफ चैप्टर मैटर. सो आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन यू बाय डूइंग सर्टेन एक्सपेरिमेंट्स दैट व्हाट इज मैटर. यू कैन जस्ट गो थ्रू योर बुक. In that it's written what is matter. Okay, so matter is anything that has mass and occupies space, so we call it as an matter. Okay, so everything which is surrounding us, like you are sitting on your chair, table, then in your surroundings, water bottle, glass, pencil, whatever stationaries you are using, so all that comes under matter. Even you are sitting in a room, so that empty room is also having air surrounding. Then in liquids, you have the example of milk, water, or any other liquid. So solid, liquid, and gas, all three conditions are coming under state of matter. So finally, matter is classified in three states, that is solid, liquid, and gas. So now let us perform an activity to show first activity, that matter occupies a space. Now you can see on your screen certain objects are kept, like marker, pencil, pen, steel scale, eraser, and sharpener. So these are all matter, or we can say solids. So these are occupying certain space. So this is our first activity, that matter occupies space. Now let's perform our second activity. So in this activity, we are going to show that water occupies space. So here on your screen, you can see two bowls are there. One bowl is empty. You can see this bowl is empty. Nothing is there except air. Okay. So air is also occupying certain space. Now here you can see water is there. I am shaking so that you can easily see that water is occupied space, half of the bowl. Clear? So this proves that liquid or water occupies space. So this liquid is also a matter. Now activity number three. In activity three, we have to show that air occupies space. So here, in previous second activity, I have shown you two bowls. In one of the bowl, water was there, and one bowl was empty. So that empty bowl was having air in it. Okay. Next example, I can show you. Like, let us keep a piece of paper, okay, a crushed paper. So we can see that crushed paper is also having air in it. Clear? In your book, example of balloon is given. So for balloon, you can just fill air in it so that you can observe the inflat balloon and a flat balloon. The difference you can see, okay? Now let us come to another activity. For activity number four, we have to show that a substance has mass. So for mass, we can just weigh it, the substance. Like supposing if I am having this bowl half filled with water, so we can just measure its mass. Okay, so whatever substance we are taking, we can just take its mass. Every substance is having mass in it, whether it is air or gas, liquid or solid. Clear? Now let us perform activity number five. In activity number five, we have to show that matter is made up of tiny particles. Now in a bowl, I have taken water. Now in this water, I am going to add salt. Clear? So let us add salt in it. I am just adding salt in it. Half a spoon I have filled. Now another half a spoon I am taking, and I am just going to mix it. So after mixing salt in it, we cannot find any of the salt particles in water because it is soluble in it. So after dissolving salt in water, we can see that the level of the water has not risen up. So this proves that matter is made up of tiny particles. Clear? Now let us come to another activity. Now I am going to show you activity number 6. In this, we have to show that molecules are in a state of motion. Okay? So now I am going to show you molecules are in a state of motion. Now you can see you have two bowls. Okay? In both the bowls, I have taken water. Now in one of the bowl, I am going to add turmeric to it. Okay? Now you can see I am adding turmeric. Now you can see without mixing, it is moving. That means water and the particles are in a state of motion. I have not shaken even, okay? But they have started dissolving in it. Now you can see I am just adding some more of, like here. Now you can see they have started moving. Okay, so now this is to prove that molecules are in a state of motion. Now in another bowl I am going to add ink, marker ink. Now you can see I am going to add marker ink to it. Okay, see now what a random motion it has shown. That means the molecules were in continuous motion. So some more I can show. Here you can see how the molecules are moving. Okay, so we have done total 6 activities, and these activities you can perform at your home as these available materials I have taken. Okay, so that you also can use the materials available at your home. So I hope you have enjoyed the activities and learned many things related to state of matter, that is solid, liquid and gas. Thank you, class.